Welcome back to the Mqtt Essentials series. In this video, we will talk in detail about the most important operations Mqtt has to offer: publish, subscribe, and unsubscribe. Let's start with publish. So as soon as a client has a connection established with the broker, it can start producing messages. And how this works is the Mqtt client produces a so-called Mqtt publish packet and sends it to the broker. And this packet has mandatory information that a client must provide. And this is topic name. And topics are important. A topic is basically a string, is a text-based string with delimiters. And this is used for message filtering. How this works in detail, we have a separate video for this, so please check this out. But what you need to know for now is that a topic is a string with delimiters, and this is a hierarchical topic. And this must be provided because this is really the data it is sent to. Then we have a quality of service level, which is a unique feature we will also see in a dedicated video. retainFlag, this is for the retain message feature, one of the most unique features of Mqtt. But also here we have a dedicated video on how this works exactly. And then we have the so-called payload field. The payload field is responsible for carrying all the relevant information. And this could be like an image file, this could be a XML file, a JSON file, a Google protocol buffers, or some arbitrary bytes you decide to send. And then we have some other flags the protocol requires, like the duplication flag and the packet ID. This is really for the protocol flows. And this needs to be carried over a publish packet. You can send up to 256 megabytes, but usually Mqtt packets are below 1 kilobyte or 1 megabyte. But you can also carry a lot of payload here. And so what happens is the client sends the published packet to the broker, and the broker would find out who is subscribed to it and then sends the same packet to multiple clients. So we have this kind of amplification. So a single message can be produced to multiple messages. So multiple clients can receive the same message. And then the published packet is acknowledged with a so-called pub-ACK packet, or if we have a quality of service flow, we have more packets here. But we will look at this in the quality of service chapter. Now let's look at another important operation called subscribe. So if a client wants to receive data from a broker, it sends a so-called subscribe packet. A subscribe packet is a very simple packet. A client decides to send pairs based on a so-called topic filter and on a quality of service it wants to receive messages on. And a single subscribe packet can carry multiple of these pairs, so you can carry multiple subscriptions into a single subscribe packet. And this is important. When we talk about Mqtt, we usually have thousands or even millions of topics, which is very unique here. And then we have the sub-ACK packet, which comes back from the broker. And the sub-ACK packet basically tells the client if the subscription was granted or not. So based on other things like the permissions and so on. And the last important packet is the so-called unsubscribe packet. And the unsubscribe packet is used if you don't want to receive a data stream anymore from the broker. You will send a packet with multiple topics which you want to unsubscribe to, and then the broker acknowledges you that packet with an unsub-ACK. And so, to summarize, we have three important packet flows. We have the publish packet, we have the subscribe packet, and the unsubscribe packet. And publishing is for producing data, subscribing is for receiving data streams. And by the way, you receive the message stream for these topics as soon as the broker sends you a sub-ACK. And then with unsubscribe, if you don't want to participate in the message stream anymore, you can unsubscribe and the broker stops sending you messages again. So we will talk about all these features now in detail in the next videos. So stay tuned here. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next videos.